Hello friends, in this tutorial I am going to give you an introduction of an Arduino Uno board. However, various types of Arduino boards are available in the market, but Arduino Uno is the most popular among them. Therefore, I have covered Arduino Uno board in this tutorial to explain about the physical components and peripheral devices and special features of it. Physical components means the components mounted on the board. I will explain about the connectivity and other components, hardware and software components required for the programming part in my upcoming lectures. So first of all, we'll see the Arduino Uno board. Now this is the Arduino Uno board. On this board, we can see a microcontroller ATmega328P. Some other components are also there, 9-volt adapter jack. Here we provide a power supply. This is USB plug, a reset button. Crystal is placed on this. This is a metallic crystal. LM1117 regulator IC. It converts a 5 volt into 3.3 volt. L1 is a light LED. LED2, LED3 and LED4. There are 4 LEDs. This LED4 is a
LED
power
one
LED.
Is connected to pin number 13 of digital IO port, whereas LED2 and LED3 both are transmitting and receiving signal LEDs.
Digital input output ports on the top side pins. Here on the bottom side, analog pins are there, A0 to A5. There are 6 analog pins we generally use to connect sensors over here. These are the power pins. Power pins, we get 5 volt supply or 3.3 volt supply from these pins. So this is the Arduino Uno board. Now we are going to see the ATmega328 microcontroller, which is the most important element of Arduino Uno board. This microcontroller has a lot of features, but few of them I am going to discuss here.
ATmega328 microcontroller is an 8-bit AVR microcontroller. AVR is a series of Atmel company. So in this microcontroller, we can see here D0 to D7, these are the 8 bits. These 8 bits may be either 0 or 1. So this is a combination of zeros or ones shown below. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. This is actually the binary number of a 06 representation. So this type of data can be stored in this microcontroller. With the help of a block diagram of AVR microcontroller architecture, we can see here that 8-bit data bus is connected with the internal components of microcontrollers. These components are program counter register, status and control register, general purpose register, arithmetic and logical unit ALU, SRAM, static RAM, electrically erasable programmable read-only memory EEPROM, IO lines, interrupt units, serial peripheral interface SPI, watchdog timer, analog comparator, and IO modules. Now we are going to see the inbuilt memories of AVR microcontroller, specifically ATmega328P. This microcontroller has mainly two memory spaces, flash memory, that is a program memory space, and data memory, that is a SRAM. So in addition to these two memories, there is another memory space, that is a electrically erasable programmable read-only memory EEPROM. As far as a flash program memory is concerned, it is a memory space where our program, which is made on Arduino.exe, integrated development environment software, we can store that program into it. So its capacity is 32 kilobytes. It is an on-chip in-system reprogrammable memory. It means that we can reprogram it again and again as and when required. But there's some limitations. It is around 10,000 times we can rewrite any program in it. Next thing is how it is organized. Actually, AVR instructions are 16 or 32 bits wide. So that's why it is organized in such a way that it can accommodate these instructions in it. So that's why AVR microcontroller's flash program memory is organized in 16K cross 16 format. Another important point about the flash program memory is the software security. This flash program memory space is divided into two sections, bootloader section and application program section in Atmega 328. Pictorically, bootloader section is on the bottom side and application program section is on the top side. Another inbuilt memory space of Atmega 328 microcontroller is data memory. It is also known as SRAM, static random access memory. Its size is 2 kilobytes. It holds the temporary data during the programming process. This figure shows the data memory map of Atmega 328 microcontroller. Here you can see various sections are there. 32 register section, 64 I/O registers, 160 extended I/O registers, internal SRAM, 2048 cross 8. This is the size of a RAM. In addition to the flash program memory and data memory, that is SRAM, there is a separate memory space called EEPROM, electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. In this memory, we can store the data like passwords, which is required to be used even after power failure. Again, if we reset the system, we need it again. So we can say that it is a non-volatile memory. It retains the data even after power failure. Its size is 1 kilobytes. It has an endurance of 1 lakh times. It means that we can rewrite this memory up to 1 lakh times. So this is a very brief introduction of internal memory spaces of Atmega 328 microcontroller. And now we are going to see about the peripheral features of Atmega 328. In this microcontroller, various peripheral features are available. Some of these features are mentioned over here. Two 8-bit timers, / counters. It means that the timers can be used as a counters also. So there is no separate circuitry for counters. So one 16-bit timer / counter, real-time counter with separate oscillator, 6 pulse width modulation channels, PWM channels, 6 channels, 10-bit ADC, analog to digital converters. So its accuracy is 10 bits. Programmable serial USART, universal synchronous asynchronous receiver transmitter. It is programmable. It is used for serial communication. Programmable watchdog timer with separate on-chip oscillator. This watchdog timer is very useful at the time when there is a gadget which is being used for the applications where we cannot reset our system at the time of a malfunctioning. So we use a watchdog timer there. Interrupt and wake up on pin change. These features can be used to suspend the main program functioning and execute the subroutine program. Some special features of a microcontroller Atmega 328 are mentioned here. Power on reset, external and internal interrupt sources, various sleep modes like idle sleep mode, power saver sleep mode, power down sleep mode, standby and extended standby mode. Whenever we provide the power supply to the system becomes resets automatically and starts from the beginning. This is called power on reset. Interrupts may be of two types, external interrupt and internal interrupt. External interrupts are the interrupt signals given by the external devices connected at the input pins, whereas internal inputs are the signals generated by the program itself with the software command. Sleep mode is very useful feature of a microcontroller in terms of power saving. It is very similar to the PC or laptop. If you are not using it for a long time period, automatically it goes into the sleep mode. Similarly, in this microcontroller, there is a feature of a sleep mode.
So this is all about the introduction of Arduino Uno board.